Welcome to the Art Rant Stream. Now, we're going to talk about art, but before we begin, I suppose we should get on with some things. Why do I care so much? The answer is that art is the wonder and the passion of the human soul. The creative force that drives us forward as a species. The opposite of the droll reality that we currently live in ourselves. I'm just trying to be pretentious and say that art is fucking important, you dumbasses! And yes, anything can be art, and anything should be art, but that doesn't make it good art. But before we begin, let me just rectify in saying, howdy, I'm gonna leave some classical music on while I, before we begin. Now, let us begin with art that I don't think is actually all that bad. To give you a baseline, to give you an understanding of what I think is actually decent art. Let us go with this example. This is called The Mutt, or The Toilet. I believe this piece here fucking brilliant. It was created as a fuck you to the art community of the time, basically saying, you know what, I bet you, I could put a fucking toilet in a museum if I claimed it to be art. And they fell for it! And they went for it! They actually did it! The bastards! Glorious! Wonderful! So yet again, this is good art. This is what art should do. Art should set out to create an emotion, or a feeling, or an idea, or just show the creativity of the work in general. I don't know, I'm not an art theorist. I don't have a doctorate in art. Art history? This is just some jabroni on the internet! But this piece here is what I think is a good baseline for decent art. So, yeah, I don't hate this. I don't hate this kind of art. I don't get people ranting about it. But let us move on to more art that I think is actually pretty okay. I don't get why people hate Jackson Pollock as much as I... This, to me, is not aesthetically pleasing art. Like, I think there are certain aesthetics and ideas that you can possess as a person and as an artist and go, this is not for me, and while technically I don't like it, and aesthetically I think it's not all that great, I don't see why people hate Jackson Pollock's work so much. Let's bring up some more Jackson Pollock while we're at it. Jackson Pollock art. Well, we're here because I figured I want to show you what I mean by that. This is just my example to go off of. As you can see, I'm not, like, aesthetically, this is, not the thing that I get. I don't understand this aesthetically. To me, it just looks like a bunch of splotches of painting on a canvas. But at least it takes effort. It takes some sort of artistic force and creativity to do this. To me, that says something. I don't like it, but it's a thing. You understand what I'm saying? Like, look, I don't get it. Not my cup of tea. I don't like it all that much. This kind of stuff just isn't, like, my cup of tea, as you could clearly see, but at least it takes something. It takes an effort. It takes an idea and a statement to do this bullshit. My dog barks. Now we're gonna get into the stuff that I don't, that I like still a little bit, but bullets too slow. Yes, indeed. Howdy, Mr. Puffy. Welcome to the art. I rant about modern art stream. One moment, please, and thank you. I'm getting a phone call. Thank you. Okay, we're back. Heyo. Let us get on with more things that I think are decent, just to set a baseline. I don't get why people hate brutalism. I think it looks neat. I think it looks like turtle meat. This, to me, not bad. Not bad at all, in my humblest of onions. Do I understand why some people think that brutalism is not an interesting architectural style? You bet your bippy I do. But do I think it is bad? No. Now let's move on to the final piece that I think is at least decent, and I'm going to have to censor this piece because of Twitch's more puritanical nature. This is called The Loathsome Cowboy. I had to censor this because, well, it has cock in it, but I love this piece. To me, this piece is absolutely beautiful. It says something wonderful about, like, the nature of modern sexuality and the nature of art and pornography in itself. 10 out of 10, Loathsome Cowboy. You truly are something to behold. Sadly, I cannot show you all that much because of, well, the nudity. Because of the titty and the cock and the penis and the balls. Let's move on to something that does piss me off. The taped banana bit. Now, for those of you who may not be aware, some artist, I can't remember where, decided, hey, fuck you, I'm gonna tape a banana to a wall. What does this say? What is this trying to say? What is this message is it trying to convene? Is it that, haha, I scammed you out of money, you dumbasses? If so, congratulations. You did the thing. Congratulations. You scammed the art world. But I don't think it's saying anything. It's not conveying a message. It's not creative. I could duct tape my cock to a wall and declare myself Alexander the Great of Russia. But no way would that in way be good art. It would just be some jackass duct taping his cock to a wall and declaring himself Alexander the Great of Russia. It doesn't say anything. It doesn't mean anything. It just feels like a scam. That is the biggest problem with modern art today, in my opinion, is that a lot of it just feels like a money laundering scam. And I know people have said this. I know people have said this, and it's true. But a lot of modern art really does feel like a money laundering scam. It really does feel like a scam, you know what I mean? Who on earth did this and why? For what reason? Yet again, I don't get it. I don't like it. It's not even aesthetically pleasing. Like, they didn't do anything to the banana. Let us move on, shall we? Bad restorations. Here we see a restoration of Christ that goes... I'm sure you've seen this as an image, as a meme, but... What chuckle fuck? What goddamned ape moron do they get to restore this painting? What moron, what fool, what rube did they intend to do this on? I want you to think about this. I want you to think about this. Like, technically, it's beautiful. Technically, still beautiful. I'm using my mouse. I don't know if you can see it or not, Chad, but I'm pointing to it with my mouse. I don't know if you see that on screen or not, but the second one. Can I? Okay, you can see, right? You see the middle one, right? That's where it's being damaged because of time. And then we have this third one here that looks like an ape drew it. I want you to understand this, chat. This kind of restoration bothers me so. Let us move on, shall we? Now we're going to go on to a trend in modern art, and art in general, that I find annoying. Let me just get this. Blank canvases, or canvases colored one or two colors. I despise this. Aesthetically, it is boring. There's just a color. Oh my god, wow. You're so smart. You're so clever to do this. Wow, what a brilliant statement you're saying. To me, this screams, this reeks of pretension. This reeks of I am better than you. My daddy bought this for $1 million and your daddy didn't kind of vibe. You know exactly what I say when I mean this. This to me feels like someone just paid their shitty kid to do a painting for like $1 billion and then fuck you, here it is. It takes no talent. You could literally... I'm going to show you on my computer. We're going to get paint, chat, so I can show you. One moment. We're getting paint so I can show you why I hate this trend, and then we'll move on to the others of this trend, and you'll understand why I despise this trend. I apologize greatly. Of course we're going to use MS Paint. What are we, uncivilized or something? Let's remove this image for a second. Screen, window. Here we see MS Paint. The MS Paint of choice of all jabronis everywhere. Let us begin by coloring this a singular color. That'll be $1 billion, please! That will be $1 gorillion, please. $1 gorillion, please. In fact, I'll put a money sign on it so that my daddy knows to buy it for $1 billion. There you go. Money. Yes! Art! See, that takes more effort than those fucking things. I cannot stand canvases with one color. That, to me, is the antithesis of, art. And good art, too. Now let me show you something else that I hate, and I think is a scam. Wow! Wow! Look! I'm a genius, chat! This kind of shit, I absolutely hate here, chat. This kind of shit, this trend, this style, this thing where they just do one color or another color on a canvas with like a line, like a black or white line, to me that is creatively bankrupt. It is the antithesis of good art and good art design. Let us remove MS Paint for now. Just, that was for demonstration purposes, chat. Okay, where am I? Oh yeah, colors on a canvas, the bullshit trend that I despise more than I can have words to put in you. I hate this trend. Let's show you more examples of this trend so you understand how much I despise it. Look at this! What does this say? What does this mean? It's just fucking three streaks of color intersecting with some other colors. Wow! Bravo! Creative genius! Wonderful art! Yes, He-Man! makes my bussy creamy and good, yes, He-Man. Ah, the creaminess. Oh, I'm creamy everywhere. Daddy, give me $1 billion so that you can buy this and give this to your friends. Why won't you love me, Daddy? Eh.
It really does scream of someone just paying their kid to shut the fuck up about their art school. I'm sorry. Art matters to me. I care a little too much. Look at this! Yet again! Pretentious bullshit! I despise it! Oh, how I hate this trend! I don't even know what this is called, but I fucking hate it! Oh, this boils my tacos! Oh, this boils my lava, chat! This burns my biscuits! I cannot describe to you how much I dislike this, I apologize. And if you make this kind of art, I'm sorry. You're probably a good person. But why? There are so many different styles. Yet again, I don't get this. Simple colors on a canvas. Are you trying to say, oh, look at the contrast between these two lines? Like, okay, I get that. That would be good if you're trying to say that. But this is a trend I just do not like, and I'm truly sorry. I don't get this trend. It's just... oof. That is a trend I do not like in art. Now, this I actually kind of like. Because this actually takes a little bit of talent to create these little individual squares on a wall with each individual colors. To me, this actually is probably the best version of this trend because it takes some form of talent and it takes some idea of color theory and what contrasts and what doesn't work, and it takes real patience to, color those very small individual lines of paint and make sure that none of them bleed over each other. To me, this is the best possible version of this, and I think this is probably what most people who are trying to do the one color on a canvas thing should actually attempt to do. I actually kind of like this, and it's even from a trend I don't necessarily care for. So you can do trends I don't like in good ways. How about that, chat? You can do trends in ways I... trends of things I don't like in actually good ways. Wow. Yet again, not what I would consider aesthetically pleasing. This red one, at least it's speckled. This black one... no, I like this blue one in the back there. That I actually think is good looking, but these two at least have an idea to them. Like I said, there are versions of this trend that I think can be good. And then there are versions of this trend that I think are absolutely pretentious. Like this! Fuck this! I'm gonna get out the whiteboard again, chat, and I'm sorry. There! Now it's art! Now it's art, chat. See? Now it's art. Okay, we're moving on. Yet again, trend I do not care for. Ugh,
I cannot stress how much I dislike this trend. To me, this looks like someone just slashed the canvas with an axe, and then painted that slash. It's not for me, my dude. I'm sorry. I don't like this sculpture. It reminds me of my nightmares. That's about it. That's all I have to say about this sculpture here. Imagine this thing coming into you as you sleep, going, "Hey kid, you wanna buy some crack cocaine? I will give you forever!" Yum. I don't like it. Don't look good on my humblest of onions. Now we move on to another trend that I find annoying. Buckle in your seatbelts, this is gonna be a wild ride, kids. CalArts art style, as some people have deemed it. Or as some people call it, the bean mouth. Now, I can understand attempting that over time, certain styles in animation will naturally happen as part of a decade. Certain artists will collaborate and certain styles become popular. I understand this. But my big problem with this style is that it is fucking everywhere. I am literally tired of it. And I understand that you're trying to do, like, an appealing design. That I understand. You want to make your show look good. You want to make your show look nice. But to me, this design art style is just... it's everywhere, and I'm tired of it already. And it's not inherently bad. This art style can be good. This art style can be great, in fact. But the problem is that it is everywhere, and I'm just tired of seeing it everywhere. I think we need to move on and find a new style, is of my humble onion. As you can see, it's everywhere. Look at this. Everywhere. And there are differences between these bean mouth styles. Like that. I don't know why. I need to get the writing board to demonstrate. I apologize greatly. You can see that these two characters... vastly different, correct? Let's say this character here. But to me, the general shape, the general outline is the same, and it's basically everywhere. And I am vaguely sick of it, to say the least. It's just everywhere, and... also, the thing that bothers me about this is that when people complain about it, the artists get mad, and I understand. When you work on something, and when you really do a lot of work and a lot of hard work, because animation is hard work, you probably would get defensible about your artwork and some asshole going, "CalArts!" But the thing is, you know that this art style is dead. You know that this art style has been done to death. And maybe it's not what you wanted to draw. It is very possible. You know, hey you, fuck the audience attitude that I don't like. It's the I am better and more smarter than you attitude that I don't care for. When people try to defend their art, like, please... understand that people are just tired of seeing this art style, and maybe you are tired too, and maybe you're just doing this because that's what the studio wants from you. That's fair, you know? I get that. I understand. I am trying to be reasonable with you, the artist who's making this, right? Like, look, this is the new Aquaman cartoon. Why is this in an action cartoon? This art style, I think, really doesn't work for action cartoons. At least in my opinion, it doesn't work for action cartoons. I feel like maybe you need a more comic book inspired art style, but that is of my opinion. I may be incorrect. And I understand, yet again, that maybe this is just you being forced by by the producers or the industry to fit your style into that mold. But you don't gotta be an asshole about it when defending it. That's where I'm gonna draw the line at, you know, my dude. Let's get on to bad architecture. Because I feel like that's a round we can talk about. And let's see what Google thinks is bad architecture and what I think is bad architecture. I apologize greatly on behalf of the British Broadcasting Corporation. Now, good art design is hard, yet again. And architecture is hard, yet again. I'm not gonna shit on you for this. I'm just gonna say it isn't appealing to me, and I don't understand the style. Let us move on, shall we? Yeah, there we go. This fish building, I like it. I think it's kind of cute, actually. I don't get why people think this is bad. Seriously, huh? People think this is bad, huh? I don't think it's bad at all, though. I think it's pretty neat looking, but that's just me. Not my cup of tea. They think the St. Louis Arch is bad. Huh. To me, this I'm not a big fan of. This architectural design doesn't really speak to me as a person. Like, I don't mind brutalism as a style, but this I don't get this here, chat. I'm pointing to it with my mouse if you can see that. But to me, it is. I don't like it. It doesn't aesthetically please me, but I can't call it bad. You know what I mean? Yet again. Aesthetically not pleasing, to me at least. But is it bad, is the question.
And yet again, these extraneous details, they're not necessary. You could do something with the chest there area too. If you wanted to make Thor armored, then go with a more armored look. It's like everyone looked at Spawn in the 90s and thought, yeah, that design is cool, and they didn't understand why it was cool. I swear that was, and there were some terrible comic book character designs in the 90s in my humblest of onions. Yet again, the armored trend. I'm not a fan of armored trend costumes. Now, this might be a little less annoying because, yet again, we have to think of Daredevil as a character. Daredevil doesn't really have any innate superpowers besides like his super senses, like his radar sense and all that stuff. So it would make sense for him to wear an armored costume, but the problem is, where is it armored? Why is it armored like this? Why is the armoring like this? Now, the coloring, I think, is nice. I like the darkish blue and the red and silver accents. I think that is okay, actually. The coloring is. Because I like the dark bluish black and the red coloring accents. I think that looks nice in my humble onion. At least in my opinion, you know what I mean? I'm sorry. I apologize greatly on behalf of the British Broadcasting Network. Yet again, extraneous armor, extraneous detailing. Now with Azrael Batman, yet again, he was attempting to be a parody of 90s comic book characters and 90s aesthetic designs, so I don't think we can really call his costume bad if it's meant to be making fun of the worst trends in 90s costumes, now can we? And you could probably do these costumes and do this look good, but if you didn't know who any of these characters are, you wouldn't understand, you wouldn't know, you wouldn't care. Like, you can't tell me that the first guy is Dr. Frickin' Fate, right? That is meant to be Dr. Fate. How would you know that? There's a reason why iconic designs are iconic, chat, is what I'm saying. For our last one, oh boy, well, I gotta go find the why does Captain America have armor here? Let us look at this from a standpoint. Captain America is a super soldier. Why in good gravy does he have armor on? Now I can understand his shield, right, Chet? Because that's part of his iconic design. But you think that a super soldier, someone who's at the peak of human fitness, right, whose costume is already armored in itself. Cap's costume already has Kevlar and chainmail armor underneath it, under where his chest and other parts of his body are at, so that he can not get killed by a bullet. And he also has his indestructible shield. So, why the extraneous armor detailing? Yet again, design a costume that you understand for your character. What are you going for? What are you looking at as a person? Thus ends my modern art rant for the, well, forever, I suppose. You can see the things I don't like in art. And I do apologize if I've offended anyone here during this little rant stream. I'm gonna, I don't know if I want to play Terranigma or not. But, you know, I believe that children are the future. I made this, chat. I want you to think about my artistic aesthetic and understand that I, the big streamer man, maybe know nothing what I'm talking about when I say I don't like modern art all that much. I really do think some of it was a scam. I can show you some more shit I think is kind of egregious in my humble onion if I have it saved on my computer. One moment, please. Truly, we should have more skeletons, more switches, more skeletons, more switches, more skeletons, more switches, more skeletons, more switches, more skeletons, more switches. That's not what I was looking for. I just thought it was funny. I'm sorry. Why can't I find this? Why can't I find this? I can't find it, chat. Oh, well, here's this. What just happened? Why can't I find the thing I was gonna show you? Yeah, that was good, yeah. Well, here's my better BRB image, and we're gonna, I think this is aesthetically pleasing. It matches the overall idea of the finger monsters. A nice BRB, simple, straightforward, not overly complex. A nice TV to imply that my stream's like a television show. I think this is good, in my humble onion. Do I think all my art is good? No! I could show you my art and tell you what I think is bad about it. Let's do that, shall we, actually, while we're on it. Because I want to shit on myself. It is time to shit on yourself, Ted. Now, what is wrong here? Yet again, I like swirls and extraneous colors in the background when I'm doing photo editing. I don't know why I find it aesthetically pleasing, but what is this piece trying to say? What am I trying to say here as an artist? I'm trying to be a fucking pretentious knob is what I am. Oh, look at culture. Look at the standard of beauty. I'm Ted. I think I'm smart. I'm not smart, chat. I ain't. No, but for seriously, it is now time to BRB, and I'll be back with something, maybe something else. I'll be right back in a little bit. I need to take a small break to get some water. And let's listen to Katamari's music. I like Katamari Damacy. Na 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 na.
やめるんじゃない。ピースなバイブレーションでアークを描き、このアースに負けないオブジェを作れ。
チゲダマファンキーだ、みんな黙って俺についてこい。チゲダマファンキーだ、みんな必死で俺についてこい。カモン。チゲダマファンキーだ、みんな黙って俺についてこい。チゲダマファンキーだ、みんな必死で俺についてこい。チゲダマファンキーだ、みんな黙って俺についてこい。チゲダマファンキーだ、みんな必死で俺についてこい。カモン。チゲダマファンキーだ、みんな黙って俺についてこい。チゲダマファンキーだ、みんな必死で俺についてこい。カモン。
Hey, I'm back, and now it is time for what I like to call the Tumblr Redesign Lightning Round! That's right, Tumblr redesigns. They're terrible. They're awful. I don't care for most of them. And this is going to be the lightning round of them, so buckle in your seatbelts, chat. We're in for a wild ride here with the Tumblr Redesign Lightning Round! Look, this is the first one. This is supposed to be the Kill a Kill cast. Let us tell you what is with all the hair. What is with all these colors? Why the noses yet again? Now, I can understand you want to make your art more diverse of body types and of beauty standards. That's a fine pursuit. But is it a good pursuit, you may ask yourself? The answer is probably no, because the thing is, Kill a Kill has a, I guess, Japanese cast? And why? It's just, you have to think about it. Think about aesthetics in your art. The Tumblr lightning round only begins from here. We can continue with the Tumblr redesign art lightning round. Yet again, you could tell something. Look at these colors. Look at the angles at which you're creating here. Think about it, Tumblr redesign artists. Seriously, what the fuck? This is one of those infamous Tumblr redesigns. Why the realistic faces? What's with the weird shading and weird... Why give them the splotches? Why? For what reason? For what purpose do you do this? To me, Tumblr redesign artists, I ask you these things, and yet you do not answer me. God is dead. God is dead. God is dead and we killed him. God is dead and we killed him. I just want you to focus this on this more in a little bit. I just want you to focus on this a little bit longer. And think about what they've done wrong here as an artist. Okay, let us move on to the other parts of this lightning round here, chat. For what purpose? Is this a parody? Are you trying to make fun of Tumblr redraws in this art here? Are you? You some kind of genius of satire? And I, but a mere man, am falling for your bait. Is this meant to be a parody? Am I falling for the bait, chat? Am I falling for this ruse? Have I?
been pranked, bro.
Okay, so this artist is kind of infamous for, well, kind of racism! Now, I want you to ask yourself, who are these characters, Chad? No wrong answers here. It's okay. It's okay, class.
Yes, class. We can decide who these characters are, yes. I want you to think about it. I want you to think about who these characters are specifically, and you will get a cookie if you are right.
If you said Captain fucking America and Tony fucking Stark, congratulations, you've gotten yourself a cookie. Congratulations, you got yourself a cookie. Yet again, how is this Captain America? I want you to look at this. Look at Cap's nitty tube arms! Sorry. Okay, I'll stop. It won't be this loud. Look at Cap's meaty tube arms, chat. I want you to look at it. Look at it, chat. It's bad. Yet again, I ask you, is this a parody? Is this meant to be making fun of Tumblr redesigns? And I use that term generally loosely. When I say Tumblr, I mean anywhere who, you know, just art redesigns in general, but it was a big thing on Tumblr back in the day, back when I still went on Tumblr, you know? I'm sure Twitter, I'm sure a lot of art communities do that, and now for the final one in our lightning round here. One that I think is a joke. One that I'm sure. Look, I get it. You want to create diversity. You want to create shapes and bodies that you don't see a lot in anime or in media in general, and you want to create that. You want to make your art something that will be good for everyone, right? You want to be diverse. You want to show people, you want to represent people, and that is a noble cause, for sure. I understand this. But to me, this screams of trying too hard to force diversity onto something that was pretty, like, all the characters in Sailor Moon are Japanese, I believe. I believe they are all Japanese, Chad. And thus, that is the lightning round completed. I'd like to thank you for coming. It means a lot to me that you come to these streams, you know. You don't gotta. Now to sign us off on something. Okay, I'm gonna make a small BRB, and we'll be back with something else. Okay. boy, we are experiencing, technical difficulties getting my controller to work. I don't know what it is, but, I don't want to fiddle with the controller, so let's just, let us just say goodbye for now. Goodbye, JoJo's. It's been swell knowing you all and ranting about modern art. Tomorrow I will be back with Terranigma. Have a nice day, all. Goodbye, JoJo's.